Welcome to this video, the ultrasound diagnosis of corpus luteum. Almost everyone is aware of follicle development, which is necessary to conceive. But the corpus luteum is hidden in most cases. It forms when a dominant follicle ruptures and releases a mature egg during ovulation. The remnant of the follicle then develops into corpus luteum. It is a vital temporary gland in the ovary that plays a key role in the menstrual cycle and the establishment and maintenance of early pregnancy by producing essential hormones like progesterone and smaller amount of estrogen and inhibin A. Ultrasound can well monitor corpus luteum growth and regression during the menstrual cycle and in early pregnancy where it is a normal finding. This is the 18th day of the cycle. The uterus is well visualized. This is normal. The endometrial cavity is 9 mm. This is also normal. We can see clear free fluid in the right adnexa and cul-de-sac. In the right ovary, we can see a cystic area of size 17 × 11 mm. Typical corpus luteum size ranges from 10 to 30 mm. It has thick and irregular walls with internal hyperchoric debris. The internal acugenicity can be variable and can appear anechoic or different level of low-level echoes and debris. Even in some cases, it may appear solid. Doppler shows a ring of increased blood flow around the periphery of the corpus luteum, indicative of its vascular nature and hormonal activity. If the released egg is not fertilized and pregnancy does not occur, the corpus luteum begins to break down about 10 to 14 days after ovulation. Its progesterone level decreases and it triggers menstruation. If the egg is fertilized and pregnancy occurs, the corpus luteum is maintained by a hormone called HCG, which is produced by developing embryo. The corpus luteum continues to produce progesterone, supporting the pregnancy, typically for the first 10 to 12 weeks, after which it gradually resolves. Sometimes the corpus luteum can fill with more fluid and forms a small corpus luteum cyst. This is common in early pregnancy and resolves spontaneously by the second trimester around 12 to 14 weeks. Most of these are asymptomatic, but sometimes the patient can feel pain due to rupture or bleeding. Thanks for watching the video.